Well, this is video number 5 in the YouTube Helm mini course on Helm. When you're working with a predefined chart, you're almost certainly going to need to customize the operation of that chart, and you typically do that using something called chart values, and we'll be looking in detail at how to do that in this video. I am assuming in this video that you've followed the previous part, so if you have just landed on this video, then it might well be worth checking out the playlist that I have for this mini course down below, and also there's a link in the description below to my full Kubernetes and Istio courses. If you're enjoying these videos and you haven't already, it would be fantastic if you could subscribe to the channel, because I am planning on producing more of these mini courses in the future. Welcome back, and in the previous video we used Helm to install the Prometheus stack, which is a pretty complicated stack of software, but we've installed it into the cluster with pretty much a simple command, which all feels very nice, but of course we're going to have to configure it somehow. So in this video, I'll show you how we configure Helm charts, but probably more importantly, how do you find out what is possible with a particular Helm chart? And as a motivating example, I think I'd like to go with this, which is the login for Grafana. It's asking us for an email or username and a password, and of course, we never configured that. Now, I guess we can probably go to the web page for this chart, and I'm hoping that it might tell me what this password is. But now, I'm running this Prometheus in my own cluster. It's private. I'm not accessing it to the web. So actually, I'd like this to be not very secure. I would like this to be the username of admin and the password, exactly the same of admin. Now, I have to say this because somebody's going to complain about this. Of course, you wouldn't do that on a production cluster. You would only do this if you're in a secure environment, blah, 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 blah. You know all of that, but I need to say it. But it's not working. If I do the login there, I'm getting an invalid password. So what are we to do? Well, really, what I should be saying to you is the starting point is always going to be the reference guide for whatever chart you're installing. Now, you hope that any good chart that has been publicly published will have a good reference to what parameters are available and what you can tune. Of course, the quality of the user guides does vary from project to project. That would definitely be one approach, and it's definitely the approach that I recommend if you're doing this in real life. I realize, though, that going through documentation on a video is not very interesting, so this gives me a chance to show you an incredibly useful command in Helm. Now, you've probably guessed that any chart that we can use is going to have some configuration that comes with it. And these are called the values in a Helm chart. And what we can do for any chart that's been published is we can use the Helm show values command. And we supply into this the global name of the chart that we want the values for. By global name here, I mean the same name that we used when we did the install. So that's the name of the repository. Remember, we used the custom label there. I call that the prom repo / cube Prometheus stack. So we can try that. We're showing the values for the chart in the prom repo / cube - Prometheus - stack. And if I've spelled that correctly, we're going to get, it won't be obvious from that, but we're going to get a massive amount of output. What we're seeing here are all of the key value pairs for every single property that we can configure in this chart. Now, it is absolutely massive. So what I suggest we do, and I assume you're able to do this on whatever shell you're using, is we can repeat that command, but this time I'm going to redirect the output into a file. Now, we're going to call this file values.yaml, and the significance of that will become important later on. You can actually call this file anything you like, but I'm going to stick with values.yaml. So now we have a file, and we can open that file, of course, in any text editor. And of course, any text editor will do. Now, this is overwhelmingly big. If I go down to the bottom of this file, we've got 2,500 lines of configuration. And I hope you won't be expecting me to go through all of these 2,500 lines on this course. First thing to say is this is a YAML file, but it's not, definitely not a Kubernetes YAML file. In other words, I couldn't go in and do a kubectl apply -f on that values.yaml file. Kubernetes does not recognize this file. In fact, Helm recognizes this file, and Helm uses this to set up the pods, the services, and so on. Now, we're going to be seeing later in this course, and this is really where I'm leading to, is that we can use Helm as a generator to generate regular Kubernetes YAML as a result of the values that appear in here. But all of that's coming later. First of all, we need to have a play with this file. Now, we know that we're wanting to override the default password. So I suggest we just do a search on this file and have a look around for the phrase password. And it really was as simple as that. I've been bumped to line 628, might be different for you. Obviously, this file is going to change as they release new versions. I've hit line 628, admin password. Now, note, I did do a case insensitive search here. That just happens to be how my editor has been set up. If you don't want to use an editor, of course, I could have used the Helm show command. And if you've got a shell like Cygwin or you're on a proper operating system like Linux, I could have done a Helm show of those values and then piped that into a grep. And I could have grepped for the string password like so. That would have worked just as well. And of course, I could have done a case insensitive search with grep-i, I think. And yeah, that would have given me a result. So whatever way you do it, we've now moved on quite a way. We know that the password that we're looking for is prom-operator. But I'm not going to use that password. As I said, I want to override that password and I want to change it to be just admin. How can we do that? All of these values can be passed in and overridden at the point that we do the installation. If I recall back the Helm install command, if I run it, that will fail because we've already got this installed. But at the point of installing, what I could have done is I could have done a -- set followed by the name of the property that I'm overriding and then obviously give it a custom value. So I could have done that at the point of installation. But actually what I want to show you here is that we can also do that after we have installed the chart. And the command's almost identical to what we did at the install, but instead we do a Helm upgrade. So we have exactly the same parameters. We're going to be upgrading the installation that we're locally calling monitoring. We do still have to supply the name of the remote chart. And I've never been sure about that, but I think the reason for that is we could change this monitoring installation we've got. We could switch in a different chart. Maybe we've decided we don't like the Prometheus community version and we're going to switch to use the Bitnami version. So we can install a completely different chart and continue to call it monitoring. I don't think you'd want to do that very often, but you do still need both of these parameters. But it makes it simple because it's identical to the install command. But as I say, we can plug in here now a -- set followed by the name of the parameter and the value that we're going to pass in. So for us, the name of the value is admin password. Don't forget the capital P. And the value is, for us, it's going to be admin. Well, I'm going to do that, but I'm going to make a mistake here deliberately. And I'm doing this deliberate mistake because I do this mistake all the time when I'm working. And I'm always tearing my hair out and I never remember there's a common trap here. See if you can spot the error. But on the face of it, we just need to do -- set followed by the name of that parameter, which is admin password, capital P, don't make that mistake, equals admin. It should be as simple as that. Let's see what happens. Well, we are getting that long list of warnings. As I say, that might not happen to you, but I'm certainly not worried about that. The thing I'm looking for is when that commander's run, we're still in the status of deployed, but we're now at revision 2. Now, I'm going to be pretty quick here. I'm going to do a kubectl get PO, and I want to point out that actually none of these pods have restarted. They're all still running, and they've been running for quite a while. Keep that in mind. Now, unfortunately, and this is going to be a minor annoyance as we go through the rest of this video, we are going to fix this, and it should be pretty obvious how we're going to fix it. If I do a kubectl SVC, unfortunately, well, it's not unfortunate, it's by design. This entire chart has basically been reapplied, but with the overrides that we've provided with that set command. Well, that means that the service that we manually edited has now switched back to being a cluster IP. Very annoying. Now, of course, we can fix that, and we're going to be doing that as soon as possible. But for now, I'm afraid, if we want to test this out, we are going to have to do a kubectl edit SVC followed by the name of that service. Same routine. I won't labour this. We change the type to node port with capitals, and we add into the ports list under target port, node port colon 30,001. Same as before. Assuming that's worked, I can now switch back to the browser and do a refresh. And yes, Grafana is still accessible. But here's the error. If I type in admin, and admin, I have invalid username or password again. So what have I done wrong? As I say, I make this error all the time. And the problem is, don't forget that these files are hierarchical, exactly as any other YAML file, really. This admin password is a child of a parent block. If I go a little further up, can you see line 612 is the parent element, which is all of the configuration for Grafana. So it looks like, and I won't scroll up just now, but the configuration for Alert Manager, Grafana, and Prometheus have all been kept in their own separate blocks. And that's why this has gone wrong. If I go back, we can just recall the upgrade command. What I've really done here is I've added in a new key value pair. There's no error here. It's just added that key value pair as a kind of a top level element, and it's not being read, it's just being ignored. So what we need to do here is we need to prefix that admin password with Grafana, and we use the dot syntax here to denote that admin password is a child of Grafana. And so what you should learn from that is your typing here has to be absolutely correct as well. Otherwise, you're going to be adding new values rather than overriding existing ones. So that's quite a frustrating problem. As I say, I've lost a lot of time due to that in the past, but it is really my own stupidity, because there's one really obvious way that you can tell if your changes are taking effect. Can you guess what that is? If we run this command now, and I'm going to have to be pretty quick here, so I'm going to rush. As soon as that command gets accepted, and we have all of that horrible warnings, but I'm going to very quickly now do a kubectl get PO. I wasn't quite quick enough. I wanted to see the old pod terminating. And, oh, I was just quick enough. This that I'm highlighting is the Grafana pod that's been running for 35 minutes. It's as old as the other pods, but can you see there is indeed a new pod coming in? I've clearly just caught it at the point that the old pod was about to terminate. So in the time I've been talking, if I repeat that command, yeah, we do find that the old Grafana pod has now gone. So that clearly indicates that a change was detected in the configuration, and Helm's intelligent enough to know that it's going to have to restart that pod to pick up our new values. So that's very much more encouraging. However, sorry, one little problem, and this is the last time we will have to do this. Again, if we go to kubectl get SVC, I'm afraid, Our manual edit to the Grafana service has again been reset. We should have expected that. So I'll go back to the kubectl edit service. Tedious. We will fix this, I think, on the next video. And I'll add in a node port of 30,001. You might have noticed an edit there. I did actually put in the wrong number here. I put 31001, and I was wondering why I couldn't refresh the page. So I've come back in and corrected that to 30001, and that's okay. So back to here, and yeah, that's where I was unable to connect, but this time Grafana's up and running. So admin and admin. Now, one really confusing thing to watch out for here is when you go to press the login button here, you might think that somehow the login has failed. But I just want you to notice that there is a little pop-up here saying logged in successfully. And I must admit, when I first recorded this video, I thought, oh no, but I've been put back to the login page. Actually, what it's asking for here is it's asking me to change the password because I'm using a basic password of admin admin. So what I could have done here is I could have clicked on skip. It's a bit strange. It's not a very good graphical interface here. It's not making it clear that we're just changing the password. If you prefer, you can safely press skip. But the key thing is we were able to change one of the values that came by default with this chart, and we're able to plug in our own. But it's really tedious that every single time we make a change, the service that we're accessing here is resetting back to the default values. How can we do that? Well, you can probably guess, same process. We just need to find whatever value is responsible for setting up this service. It's slightly more complicated though, so I think we'll stop here. And in the next video, we'll see how we can make changes to the config file, the values.yaml file, and how we can apply that instead of using --set. That's coming up in the next video.